Please. Okay, anyway, Borneo. This map is hated by flankers for some reason, even though I think it's pretty good for them. And we're actually pretty good at it. Preseason, this team did really well in Borneo for some
We
reason.
lost.
So we didn't lose
Weird.
Borneo
Okay.
this season, this pre-game, preseason.
Leppy style enters
We didn't
battle.
lose almost any of our scrims during preseason. In fact, we haven't been losing almost any of our scrims now. It's just the fucking matches. But that's beside the point. For anyone who just joined Leppy, password is Lisp to the
Actually, the
server.
point is on the hill.
Well, no. Okay, anyway. What I'm saying is,
Hey, black people.
Borneo's a good map for us, and I hope it'll stay a good map for us. Now, let's just clear some stuff up, just right off the get-go, just general things. And this will apply to pretty much every
An
map.
entered
So,
channel.
when we're playing Highlander, pretty much, don't separate from like watching demos in our of our scrims. We couldn't get the demo for the match, unfortunately, but from just looking at the scrim ones, I saw that we were separating into three or four groups at times. Oh, hey, Ven, password is Lith.
Hi.
But we would separate into. Hey, please join Spec unless you're Bukowski. Okay, anyway, we'd separate into three or four groups, and that. While it's possible to do that in Highlander, it just makes for too many fair fights, and then that just makes it a DM fest. We want to avoid that at. At like I it's not that I doubt this team's DM, it's just that DM should never be the determining factor. It should actually be more about strategy and about being a better player rather than just being able to click on someone faster and they can click on you. So basically, as a rule of thumb on everything we do, two groups in on every map, two groups, and then like we never split into more than two groups, so it's always gonna be two groups, and sometimes we'll beef up one of them. So, for example, let's talk about like flank versus combo, okay? Sometimes it will just be the scout and the soldier on flank, and literally everyone else rolling with the combo. Sometimes it'll just be medic heavy demo on combo, and everyone else rolls with the flank. But really, what should be happening in every map, and I saw it especially in Steel, that we were making this mistake. What should be happening is that pretty much everyone's either rolling with the flank or with the combo, and the only people outside of that are going to ever be. Well, now that Highlander's changed as a result of the ban on the Razorback, it really is just the spy now that isn't rolling with flank or
Alter
combo.
entered channel.
That's it. Yeah, because the sniper, if their sniper's rolling with their flank, then our sniper just rolls with our flank. And if their sniper rolls with their combo, our sniper rolls with our combo. And not only does that protect our sniper from spies, but it just makes it so that less of our players die. So, really, the only person that's out of position that can, like, be on their own is the spy. Everyone else on the Highlander team is either going to roll the flank route or the combo route. And the Highlander maps, if you look at them, they're all kind of built so that it's possible to do that. There's no real three route maps, you know? And even when there are
Quality
three
entered
routes, they're close
channel.
enough together to where it doesn't dynamically affect the game if all three aren't covered. For anyone who just joined, the password is Lisp. But anyway, so that's just a general thing we have to work on, is keeping it together. So, two groups, flank group, combo group, the spy is on his own. And that's the whole team. The danger with that is
Meech
spam.
entered channel.
Spam is a huge danger when we're like so close together and when we're playing together like that. So the way to avoid that is to be very aware of where their team is and where their team is shooting, and take routes that avoid that area.
XT.
Don't stand in areas that are chokes. Okay? So like, say you're rolling with flank and you want to hold this house, don't stand in this area right back here for a long time, because you'll just get spammed out. Alright. So there's simple ways to prevent just getting spammed out. And the simplest of all those ways is literally just not standing in spam. And that's like, that'll save you more often than not in Highlander, just because there's 9 people on their team, and if they all call a focus on an area, if you're standing in that area and 9 people are shooting at it, you're going to die pretty much immediately. There's no avoiding that. You can't react to it like in sixes. In sixes, if you take a rocket, you might be able to get out of the way before you take a second rocket, or you might be able to surf away. But in Highlander, if you take a rocket, you're likely also going to immediately take a shot from the scout and a sticky from the demo, and the pyro will throw a flare in your direction. And it's just bad news. So you just don't want to stand and spam. Those, from what I saw from us playing Steel, those were our biggest weaknesses. It was not being aware of where their team was and where their team was shooting at, and it was not being in groups. It was, we would separate out. If we died, we, instead of waiting for spawns, you know, taking an extra 5 seconds to wait for someone to spawn and then moving as a group team, what we'd end up doing if we died was we would just go out in waves and get killed over and over again. This was especially apparent when we were This was especially apparent when we were trying to capture lobby. So, keep that in mind. No, please join spec, please. No, I'm sorry. The only person that shouldn't be in spec is Bukowski, honestly.
It's because I'm special.
It's because he's not
roster. He loves me the most.
Dude, I have ADHD. It is so hard for me to do this. You have no idea.
Well, we'll wait.
Alright. I'll wait for Meech to join first.
Meech, join spec, please.
Meech, you gotta be a hero.
Meech is on red now.
No, he didn't join spec, huh? Thinks he could fake me out, okay?
Come on, guys. Thanks, Ultra. Anyway, what we were talking about, those Meech didn't join. Meech isn't. He's just, he's probably not going to play a lot either way, to
I
be honest.
I see how it is, alright.
The Ultra, you're in every single screaming match, like...
But I already did a map review with this just, last season.
I know, but it's a little different. This
no,
team
it's not!
This team is different from last season.
No,
anyway, enough of this nonsense. Let's talk about this map in specific. So, of course, keep in mind the things I said. Staying in two groups, basically. And, and don't stand in spam. But besides that, this map is different, obviously, from Steel, in that we have a cart that we need to push. So, as always, when we're playing payload, cart takes priority because it's the objective. So, if we can have x3 from the beginning all the way to the end, that's great. Sometimes that might not be the most appropriate thing to do, just act appropriately. Hey, Nubinator, password is lift. Anyway, Aruji, please run spec.
He's probably not gonna play the match anyways. You can just stay in red.
Thank you. Anyway. So. Nubinator's in the game. Good.
I'm coming.
Good. Cart gets pushed all the way. Now, this first point, there's basically two areas you have to watch. That's over this hill. This hill area right here. And over here near house. Okay? And the reason why you only really have to watch those two areas is because that's the only two areas that their team is really going to have any leverage to push in, or that our team is going to have any leverage to push in. Because you see, if you try and push in through main, not only is this easily spammed out, but their sniper's just going to have easy access to you. You're going to die if you try and push it. So, this right side and the left side of the field are really the two areas a team will ever push or will ever push or defend. So if combo rolls right, flank rolls left, and vice versa. It's pretty simple. First point isn't very difficult. Their sentry will probably be either here if it's a little forward, somewhere in this house if it's really far back, or sometimes I've seen sentries really aggressive, which always go down immediately, which RNG won't do, all the way up here or even on this side. That's not usually a good place to put them. However, right off the bat, if we can push the cart, NG and Scout, all the way to about here, right before this tunnel, if we can push the cart to there and then have the Scout continue to fight for time on the cart, once it's about there, the NG can actually rotate sideways if our flank has taken this area by then. And if the NG builds a level 3 or even a mini sentry on this side, he can wrangle it over and just have a huge ruckus. Oftentimes, if flank has this area, pushing in becomes easy as soon as we have a sentry here. Because once they have we have a sentry here, they have a lot of trouble pushing back into this area. And once they have trouble pushing back into this area, flank can just pinch them off. Combo can come in from the other end, and that's pretty much first point. Now, combo, we need to get over this hill without taking too much spam. And that means kind of pay attention to where their players are shooting and which players are up. If they're all shooting onto this hill, don't cross it just yet. Wait for a bit for them to lose interest and then start crossing. Maybe while that's happening, just make sure to keep an eye out for sticky traps, make sure to keep an eye out for spies. Spies love to hide in this area because they can just drop down from this wooden area up here. So keep that in mind. Usually the push is pyro, heavy, demo, medic on the left side, and then you'll have your flankers, usually the soldier, scout, NG. That's pretty much it on the right side. And then sniper, spy, main. It's simple enough. Anyway, so you push the cart past first point. At this point, second point is very easy for a sniper to defend. So, if their sniper is very good, don't push, if you're a combo member, don't push just straight over these tracks. Push through the house. Go through house, and then you can't get sniped by the sniper. And once you get out of house, be careful with that sniper once again. Or, if you're really afraid of that sniper, you can even go drop down and then go around this way, and you'll stay out of his sightlines basically the whole time. Be careful with drop down, though, because that's essentially a death sentence if there are players in this area at all. So make sure your coast is clear before you go drop down. Either way, pushing through house and then through here, much safer, especially when they have a good sniper. And then you have basically full rein on this entire area. If their sentry is back here, which sometimes it is, getting out of house and starting to spam the sentry is a good idea. Sometimes they'll put the sentry in this house. That's when the hold can get really tricky. Basically, when they do that, the objective is to get through the backside here and then spam onto the sentry from behind. That will get it down almost every single time, because going from the front, obviously the sentry is just going to shoot you before you can get any good spam. And that sign is right there, which means that our soldier doesn't even have good access to the sentry. That sign is actually a bitch, but I think they put it there on purpose for blocking spam from the sentry. What the fuck? Anyway, don't go under here. Don't go under here unless you need to make a getaway, because you'll just die. Da-da-da. Get the sentry down on this point. Sentry and sniper down on this point are very important. And then you can push it. Once the sentry and sniper are down, there should be nothing that stands in your way. In fact, once the sentry is down, pretty much just W into them, because the sentry really is what holds this. The sniper might get a kill on you, but if everyone moves forward at the same time and into that sniper, he will die and most of their team will die. It's very easy to spam out this area, especially if their team is standing around this area near this small health pack. Stickies in this small space will just wipe out an entire team. I have seen that happen, and it's very brutal. Sentry, main focus, and then sniper, second focus, but of course don't get sniped. The cart, deceptively, is extremely important on this point. The reason being is even if you push them all the way back, the cart has a long way to travel all the way to this point. Like, it seems a lot shorter on the map underneath than it is, but it's a long fucking way, and oftentimes you'll push their team back, and then your cart will still be at the bottom of this hill. By the time you get the cart to the top of the hill, they all got spawns, and their spawn is literally right around the corner. It's right here is where they're still spawning. So they're right in front of the point. Basically, they can spawn, turn the corner, and spam the point immediately. So, have time on the cart beforehand. Like, maybe before giving up on the cart and doing something, like, getting picks so that the team can move up, maybe have the cart even, like, part of the way up this wooden area. Make sure the cart is being pushed through the second point, because I have literally seen teams be hold off the entire time second point just because of cart time. That's stupid and shouldn't happen. Second point, and then you push through tunnel. No one should ever really bother you pushing through tunnel. One thing that does happen, though, is coming out of tunnel here, the sniper will snipe you all the way from back there in garage. That's a bitch. Make sure that doesn't happen, basically. If you hug this left wall, he doesn't have sight lines, and you can still push the cart out and then continue to push it, even get up on wood. Now, this area, wood.
It's wood.
Yes, wood. If it's wood, it is wood. So, but anyway, this area can be a viable hold. If we get out of second fast enough and not, we don't lose a lot of players defending second, then this wooden area can actually be extremely effective. Keep that in mind, and when we're backing out, our combo and our flank are mostly going to try and hold up near here, so that our sentry has adequate time to set up. Because once you're pushed back from this spawn, you spawn all the way back at last, which means our engineer has to set up new teleporters, a new sentry, and a new dispenser. He's pushed all the way back. That's gonna take him at least 1.5 to 2 minutes to get all the way up, and that's a lot of time. So the team shouldn't back out all the way to house until the NG has set up at least teleporters so we're not completely lost. If we have to back out, like we just lost too many people, then we'll make that call. But try not to die. Try not to die. Try to hold as best you can up on this wooden area. This is the best place, because it has a half metal pack, half health pack, and you have high ground, and you can spam down onto them if they try coming this way, spam down onto them if they go through tunnels, spam down onto them if they go through this door. You can see all three entrances from right up here, and I can be back here healing you guys up. If you guys see them coming in, I have a quick getaway. I literally just jump down and get into garage. So, this area is very... This area is very valuable. Let's talk about defending second. I guess I didn't really touch on that. For the most part, our sentry is either going to be up there or down there. If we want to try the sentry spot in here, that's fine. Just make sure you try it in scrims before we get to the match. If we haven't tried it in scrims before the match, then don't even bother. I want us to be practiced if we do this. Because if we do this, it can be easy for the other team to push into us and spam out our sentry. And when sentry's down, second hold is down. The two areas that our two groups are going to watch are going to be hill. Hill is mostly watched by classes that can easily look downhill and just get some damage off, say the demo, the sniper, the heavy, and this house area over here is another area you watch. This is watched by people who are good in close quarters, people who can weave in and out of things easily, so soldier, scout, pyro. Pyro is good here. Engie can be right here. Okay, so we'll experiment with that a bit this week. Garage. Once they push us off of wood, or once we push them off of wood, however you want to look at it. We're in garage. My favorite sentry spot is right on this corner because it watches this area and it watches down there. The dangers with this sentry spot are that if you can't keep it up or if their team has very good focuses, it's just going to go down, like, immediately. Because what's going to happen is they're going to say, okay, the sentry's there, demo, rotate right. The demo's going to rotate right. And he's just going to spam it from here. The sentry won't even see it. So it's just going to go down. If you can't keep your sentry up in this area, try it in a scrim or two, and if it's just not working out, not every engineer can do high spam sentry spots, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that, but then try your sentry down here or down here, because again, lots of coverage, lots of coverage. If the sentry is down here, the danger now is that this half of the map isn't being covered and they get high ground if they take it. Oh geez, lag spike. That's weird. Anyway, I'm jittering. Did someone do something or is it just me? It's probably Meech's loadout. Anyway, so what we do is we watch, again, two areas. We watch this side. Usually this side, traditionally, is watched by the combo classes. And the pyro, because spies love stabbing in this area. And then we watch up here, primarily, with the flank. Those are the two areas. I'm always going to refer to it as two areas, because it's not really three. Now, this point really is the only point where it's a little more independent, because sniper can run down here and get some really good picks. He sees all the way back in the tunnel. NG, obviously, he has his meta sentry spots. When we're pushing this, the goal is to get rid first of their sentry and then their sniper. This map, traditionally, is pretty bad for the defensive team until last. It's pretty bad. The only thing the defensive team will have going for them is usually their sniper and their sentry. However, the sniper and the sentry are incredibly overpowered on every single point on Borneo. They just shut down teams on their own. So, have the sentry down, have the sniper down. Once they're down, we need to move, like, that moment. Because another thing about Borneo is that as soon as those things are down, they're up almost instantly again, because the spawns aren't as long as they are on most other payload maps for the defensive team. And it's easy to get back in position on this map. You're so sheltered. An engineer can run back up to where he needs to build a sentry and never once be in a sniper sightline. And that is incredible. That means that an NG can pretty much set up again without any sort of danger, and if you wait too long, you lose the ground. So once the sentry goes down, once the sniper goes down, you have to move in. Utmost importance right there. Now let's say they push back. They're taking house. It's getting kind of icky. We lost our sentry. We lost our sniper. Don't fret, because as long as we have enough other people, there's another hold that's extremely powerful, and it's right after third. This is third. The hold is right outside of this tunnel. So here's how it goes. They're in this tunnel, they just push the cart in. After they do that, they are in Spam City. The walls are really close to them. they really don't have another exit. It's kind of a funnel straight into our spam. So this area, if we can set it up right, if we don't need to back out all the way to last, this area can be easily spammed by demo, heavy, and soldier. Interestingly enough. Demo and soldier mostly, honestly. Blast classes in this area do wonders against teams. The heavy will be closer to this side of the map to deny jumpers from this area, because a jumper isn't going to fucking jump in from this entrance. Like, you're just going to hit this ledge. The heavy's here to deny the jumpers from this area and to also deal damage down into that pit whenever he needs to. Okay? The demo will be... I usually like running the demo on this side so that he can back out if he needs to. Like, just straight back out. And medic, same reason. So demo medic usually on this side, soldier usually near this side as well, or even on top of that ledge. Heavy on this side, pyro will be roaming this area. Besides pyro, we have our scout roaming this area as well to pick off anyone who tries to push in. Spy really concentrates on this area because the spam is going mostly into this funnel, so spy should get picks from people trying to push the other side. Sniper can just watch straight down into this hole, like from way back here, or from even any other positions. There's so many sight lines all the way back into there he can use. Let's see. Engineer. Okay, so this is the thing about this. Sometimes it's worth putting your sentry here, sometimes it's not. You have to make a quick judgment. If they're pushing us and if you don't think we're going to have the holdup, you have to build last. Because last sentry can hold forever. But if we're in decent shape, set your sentry up either on this ledge or somewhere in this area, and they will be held here for ages. Like, as long as your heavy's around this area too, the sentry and the heavy together can pretty much just demolish even an overhealed heavy. Like, it just works. I've seen it work. It's just what you should do. Of course, when we're pushing this area, again, there's two areas you can push through. Either this entrance or around. The people who are pushing through this entrance are going to be pretty much just the combo, and around is going to be the flank. Flank, your objective here is to pretty much just pinch them off so that they back off of this entrance and stop spamming it. And combo, your objective here is to get the fucking cart out of this hole. This is one of the only places on the map where the scout and the NG should not be pushing this cart anymore, because they're just going to die if they stand on it. At this point, the combo should be pushing the cart out of this tunnel, because combo's gonna have overheal, hopefully, and the spam won't kill a heavy with the Fist of Steel out. They won't kill a demo with 260 HP. That's the goal. So that's what you do until the cart gets up here, and then it goes back to normal where the scout and the NG are pushing it again. Now, last push. Pretty much you're gonna need an Uber if they have a sentry. If they have a sentry, the Uber's pretty important. But for the most part, the combo will want to go through this left side. It gets you so fucking close to their spawn, to their sentry, to their medic, to their NG. Everything's gonna be right here. So you want to take this ground. The dangers in that, of course, are that this is a hallway that can be spammed out easily, and everyone knows that. So don't stand and spam if they're spamming it. And their sniper is a huge danger there. So roll the sniper with the combo when you're pushing last. That's super important, because if their sniper's getting picks on our heavy, on our demo, on our medic, we will never be able to push. It's super important the whole combo stays alive, stays buffed, and can build an Uber in time to be able to push and to maybe even set up a spawn camp. This is pretty much the only point where it's okay to spawn camp, because the point is right here, their spawn is right above it. So at this point, this isn't really bad manners to spawn camp. This is literally just protecting your objective. So be in this area and keep them away from the cart. Keep killing them as long as you can once you have this area. Flank, of course, or whoever's not rolling with the combo, pretty much trying to push out this right side. Or through main. The reason I say or through main is because sometimes, not always, but sometimes this right side is just empty all the time. And so you think, oh, I can get ground here, and you get ground here, but then as soon as you round this corner, one of their players sees you, and they call that you're here, everyone focus fires here. Or as soon as you round this corner, same thing, everyone focus fires here. You shouldn't... Don't underestimate empty ground. When there's players here, that's very good, because when you're going into that area as a flank class, and there are players standing there, you have the high ground on them, which means you can pick them off one by one and eventually make ground that way. You want to make ground while getting picks while you're pushing into last, because in the end, the picks are going to be what matters. Even if you're spawn camping, even if you have times three on the cart, if you still have a soldier alive on their team, they're still gonna hold the cart because, as I said before, spawn times on this map are a lot shorter than on most payload maps for the defending team. Which means if their soldier is kept alive over there and your whole team is just focusing the spawn and like you only have a scout on the cart, what's gonna happen is that soldier is gonna kill the scout and then he's just gonna stand on the cart, and while your team is spamming him off, their team is going to respawn and they're gonna come out and they're gonna keep holding, and that's gonna be another 20 to 30 seconds that you could have possibly won the match in. So picks do matter when pushing into last, especially off the right side. If no one is in the right side though, like if it's just empty and you're walking around there, don't waste your time bringing attention to yourself. Rather, take this area right here, this area with these stairs, with these crates right here. And why do I say take this area? First of all, if you're in this area and not in this area over here or in this area over here with the health pack, they're not gonna call you out. If their team is all up there, they can't see you standing behind this wall. So if they don't call you out, they might just send their scout out here. Bam, free pick from the soldier. That's funny. Free pick from the soldier right there. They won't call you out is what I'm trying to say. So they'll send one person at a time and you can get free picks. Also, if the cart is pushed out to like here on the tracks and you have this area, you might as well just come out once you have the sentry down and start pushing the cart into this last stretch. Wow, my mouse is moving to the left by itself. That's really weird.
Maybe you might need to cancel the map review.
Cancel the map review?
Yeah, why? If you can't navigate with your mouse glitching.
I mean,
nah, dude, you gotta turn left
it's okay.
And go right.
I just blew on the mouse, so it's okay. Anyway.
What?
I blew on the, laser. I think there was something in it. But anyway. I guess what I'm trying to say is, this last point is a bitch to push. Make sure the sniper's down. Make sure the sentry's down. But even more important on this last point than either the sniper or the sentry is actually the medic. If we can get a meta pick for our spies, for our snipers, for anyone who might see their medic, that will win the game automatically. Because as long as our medic is up and theirs isn't, the heals will literally just kill them all and we can push the card in. Their medic is the objective. That's huge. After the medic, I'd say it's the sentry. After the sentry, it's the sniper. But pretty much that medic is, the grand goal. Once the medic is down and they're defending, it's GG. Now, let's talk about the defense on this. For the most part, our flank is going to be watching this right side. I know it's kind of counterintuitive because you're on low ground. You don't need to be pushed all the way up there, to be honest, to watch the left side. If you're just watching near this staircase, near this railing here, eventually they'll peek and you can get some spam off and chase them if you have to. But watch the left, and then our combo watches the right. What the fuck? It's doing it again. But anyway, our combo watches the right, our flank watches the left. My mouse is being a bitch. Man, I'm just gonna have to plug in my other mouse. But I'm just gonna go ahead and rotate for a bit. Anyway, combo watches the right. Why?
Because plus right and con.
Plus right. Okay. Oh, it just stopped itself. That's really weird.
Oh, it's
I don't know.
I'm a hacker.
No.
Anyway.
Okay.
Anyway, our combo watches here. With our sniper close by. Sniper peeking this is extremely effective. Keep that in mind. But don't die when you're doing it, because the demo can literally just shoot stickies up this hallway and you'll be dead before you know it. That means, combo, don't stand in this hallway, because on defense it's more important for you to stay alive than for you to get a kill. So don't stand in this hallway. Once you're inside of this hallway, if their heavy peeks that corner, and you're a demo, you're dead. There's no way you can back all the way through this hallway and get back to your medic in time. You're just gonna get focused down and die. So don't overextend through this hallway, no matter how tempting it is. The goal is to stay alive. Get the picks passively. They can't push as long as we're just, you know, doing consistent work and keeping consistent area. So keep that in mind. But yeah, this area is very important for the combo to watch. If their combo's pushing in through here, call it. If they use into here, really call it so that we can counter use and we'll have Surtur standing near here to body block. Again, flank this way and sniper focusing pretty much this hallway, or if not this hallway, then just down, straight down through main. That's pretty much the entirety of this map. As far as I'm concerned, this last push, it's pretty scary. Once it gets past these steel pillars, the cart, and if we're defending, say, pretty much once it's past these steel pillars, we want our flank constantly just watching. And by flank, I mean soldier and scout. Constantly just be ready to jump on that cart, spam that cart. Demo 2, spam the cart. If you have explosives, just shoot them at the cart if anyone, like, even looks at it funny. Like, don't even let them touch it past those steel pillars. Because if you let them touch it, not only are they going to have infinite heals and ammo for that last stretch, but it's much, much harder to get their entire team, who's going to hear that the cart is free, off of that cart. So just don't even let them think about pushing it in that last... what is it, like 10 feet or so. If we're pushing, however, pretty much past these steel pillars, we go into cart mode. Because past these steel pillars, we should have already taken out their sentry. And their sniper's not going to be able to take off an entire team from the cart. They will spam down on us, though, really, really hard, with their soldier and with their demo. So, past these steel pillars, our sniper and our spy has to get rid of the soldier in the demo immediately. As soon as we call that we're pushing into this last past these steel pillars, sniper and spy just have to be able to basically click on this demo and on the soldier, and bam, no more explosive spam on the cart. It's a free win. If we kill the medic, everyone presses W, because that shit is basically game. That's just, like, that's a death sentence. And of course, we'll experiment with that a lot. I didn't really talk about the sentry spot, but the meta sentry spot has always been on the same on this map ever since it was out in general, actually. It's pretty much on either side of these crates. Or on top of these barrels. I don't like the spot up here. I like it. Sometimes I will... You see this shit? I'll use this spot sometimes, but very rarely. And when I do use it, it's mostly when I see that their solder and their demo aren't very good. Because when their solder and their demo aren't very good, they won't be able to spam it out easily. But if they have good spam, then that sentry is just going to go down. So just next to these crates on either side is good. The dispenser back here, so that not only can the team come back for a quick health pack, but they can also get ammo replenished. Teleporters, don't even worry about the teleporters. Their spawn is literally right next to last. Are there any questions?
Favorite color.
All right, since there are no questions, I guess that's the whole map review. If anyone would like to stay and help us out and playing some fours with us, please do.